Okay, so today we're going to look at factoring a trinomial by using the X factor method by Professor G. So come along with us and you'll be happy. Alright? So the first thing that we want to try to do is factor a nice, simple, straightforward trinomial so that we can get a feel for the process. And so we're going to start with x squared plus 7x. Plus 10. All right, so no negatives or anything. Basically, the first step is factor the first term into pairs and repeat with the last term. Okay, so this is kind of the first step right here. Factor the first term and the last term into pairs. So x squared only has one pair, x times x, right? That's its factor pair. Factor means a multiple, and so that's what we've got. For 10, you actually have 1 and 10, and 2 and 5. Those are the factor pairs right there. And you'll notice that I want to go in ascending order in one of the columns because this will help us out with one of our tips and tricks. So once you've done that, factored, what we're going to do is draw an x. And this is why we call it the x factor method. And so I draw an x with the little arrows on the end because this is going to guide me to being able to fill in the blanks. Okay? Now what? Hopefully this is kind of obvious. Choose a pair for the front and back. All right? And the hint is to use closest together. All right? Together. That's a hint. So here I'm going to use X and X and I'm going to put them in the front because they were in the front. And I'm going to choose 2 and 5 because they're closer together than 1 and 10. And so I put 2 and 5 in. Okay? The second hint, which isn't applicable in this particular problem, but it's worth saying, is no GCF on a line. And of course, a line is this, right? So the X and the 2 are on a line. And here the x and the 5 are on a line. So no GCF on the same line. Okay? Now, follow the x. Alright? So x times 5 is 5x, and x times 2 is 2x. Well, you'll notice these terms right here are like terms with the 7x. And what I'd like to do is to be able to get that 7x from these two terms. And I can if I have a positive 2 and I have a positive 5. And so what we do now is determine if the pair works and determine signs. Okay, so a positive 2x and a positive 5x do give you a 7x, and so x times positive 2 gives you a positive 2x, and x times positive 5 gives you a positive 5x. So your factored form here is x plus 2, x plus 5. And the reason this method works is because if you use the distributive property, you're going to have x times x is x squared, and then you have x times 5x, right? So this was part of the x that we did. And then you have 2 times x, and there's the 2x, right, that we found. And then you have 2 times 5, which is 10. So literally, the outside two get multiplied together, And that's why we use the factor pairs. And the inside two get combined. And that's why I added those two terms from the x. Okay? So now let's try it for a slightly more complicated one. Let's factor 2y squared minus 7y plus 3. So again, factor the first terms, 1y and 2y, don't forget the y's, and then the factors of 3 are 1 and 3. And so now I draw my x. I put these guys in the front, because they're in the front. I put these guys in the back, because they're in the back. And so now I go 2y times 1 gives me 2y, and 1y times 3 gives me 3y, and those are like terms to the 7y, but now there's no way that I can get the 3 and the 2 to give me the 7. So this makes me sad, because this isn't going to work. So what do I do? Well, I sort of arbitrarily picked where to put the 2, the 1, the 3, and this one right here. So what I can do is just flip 1. So when something doesn't work, just try a flip first before you move on to something else. So I'm going to flip the back pair. And now when I multiply, I get 1y and 6y. And 1y and 6y will give me, going to go right through here, negative 7y if I have a negative 1 and a negative 6. And a 2y times a negative 3 will give me a negative 6y. And so I make this 3 negative right here. So there's my factor pair. My factor pair ends up being 2y minus 1 and y minus 3. And that makes us happy. It was a little hairy because we had to flip it once, so I give him a little hair. But there it is. Now what if we have more factors than that? So let's just go ahead and do one more example where we have more factors to choose from. The 8y squared minus 2y minus 15. So we got a lot of signs to pay attention to. So here, I want to use 1y and 8y, and 2y and 4y. And here we're going to use 1 and 15, and 3 and 5. And you'll notice I'm still using ascending order on this left column right here, because these bottom guys tend to be the closest together. And remember, our rule is we want to use closest together. So I'm going to draw my x. Fill in my 2y and my 4y, and then try to determine where to put the 3 and the 5. Well, I'm going to put the 3 up here and the 5 down here so that the small number gets multiplied by the big number and the big number gets multiplied by the small number, and so hopefully these will be closest together. And lo and behold, 4y times 3y is 12y, and 2y times 5 is 10y. And how do I combine these to get a negative 2? Well, I need a negative 12 and a positive 10. So I make this a negative 3 and a positive 5. And so by the x factor method, we have 2y minus 3 and 4y plus 5. I hope you have enjoyed our my little talk, my little video, and that you are happy going forward doing factoring.